Hello students, welcome back to our science class. I know you are all eagerly waiting for our science class, isn't it? So students, please check your textbook. Take page number 102, unit 4, science in everyday life. How science deals in our everyday life, day-to-day activities? We are going to learn what is science, why science is important in our life. Students, do you think science is separable from our day-to-day life? First, you have to know what is science. Science is the study of the natural world around us. We learn science by observing, experimenting, and describing. Science is all around us. How science is involved in daily life? For example, if you are sleeping, but your body is still working, how? Your heart will never stop the beating, isn't it? And we will dream while we sleep. It is also a science. We eat food, and what happens? It gets digested. And that work is also known as a science. Likewise, medicine, vessel, furniture, we use the products for our kitchen items, daily life, all include science. So science impact most aspects of our day-to-day life, including the food we eat, the energy, medicine, transportation, and leisure activities. So science is very important for us, and it is a very interesting topic. So today we are going to learn about the applying the knowledge of scientific principles and observing the science in our kitchen, and learn about the value of cooking items and the medicinal properties, and exploring scientific investigation in our day-to-day life. And we are going to learn about the thermometer. So shall we get into the lesson, students? The first one is the kitchen science. What do you mean by kitchen science? Yes, we can learn more science in our kitchen itself. So what is the first one is the boiling water. Yes, take a vessel, pour some water, switch on the stove. What will happen? It started to boil. It is a science. Then what is mean by boiling? Heating a liquid. Now I am heating a liquid, isn't it? What is the liquid here? Water. Heat until it becomes a gas, and it is called as boiling. And do you know what is a boiling point? The boiling point of a substance is the temperature at which the liquid boils. And here the liquid changes into gas, and that is the boiling point. And you must know the benefits of boiling water. The boiling water destroys germs, improves digestion, prevents us from the infection of waterborne disease. So next we are going to see about your favorite breakfast. We are going to learn about idli. Do you like idli? Yes, idli is a common breakfast of Tamil Nadu, isn't it? And here the science is involved. How the science is involved in idli? You have to prepare the batter, idli batter. So what are the ingredients? Rice, black gram, fenugreek, and it is known as vendayam, and salt. So the first step for idli making is soaking rice and black gram in water. And the next step is we are going to grind them. And the third step, here the science is involved, allowing it to ferment. It takes some time to ferment. Step is we are pouring the batter in an idli vessel, idli maker cooker, and your idli is ready. And it is a method of steaming. The cooking method involved here is a steaming. Do you know the benefits of steaming cooked food? It is easily digested, and the steamed food retains vitamin C and E. Can you name one more food item prepared by steaming? Very good, idiyappam. It is also prepared from rice by steaming method. And the caterers, caterer means who make foods. They prepare varieties of idlis. There are beetroot idlis or carrot idlis. To attract their customers. Okay students, then we are going to move on to a next topic, home appliances. Home appliances is a machine, the thing like electric bulbs or fans are called home appliances. We are going to see some more home appliances here. The main home appliances your mother are using is the pressure cooker. Cooking food using water in a sealed vessel is called cooker, and this method is called pressure cooking. So benefits of pressure cooker: it saves our time, minimize the usage of fuel and save energy, and it also retains nutrients in food. So shall we see some other home appliances, some commonly used home appliances? They are gas stove, mixer, grinder, vegetable cutter, kettle, electric cooker, induction stove, coffee maker makes coffee or tea. This one which we all have in your home, the refrigerator is nothing but the fridge, is a popular home appliances. It works on the principle of cooling. So students, now we have seen so many appliances used in our kitchen. Now I am going to tell you the safety measures in the kitchen. Students, you should keep in your mind the safety measures in kitchens. Never play with kitchen utensils such as knife, matchbox and glass vase, and use a cloth to hold hot pans. Inform an adult in case you smell cooking gas leakage. Turn off the gas stove, microwave oven and any other electrical gadget immediately after use. We are going to see the medicine in the kitchen. In earlier times, you can ask your grandmother, grandfather also. Kitchen medicine was practiced in every house. People know, your grandmother know, there are some ailments of the family members and manage emergency with the available product in the kitchen. Kitchen is an amazing pharmacy, you know. So let's see some of the kitchen medicines. Here first is garlic. It is called as poor man's antibiotic. It helps to balance blood pressure and reduces symptoms of common cold. The second one is asafoetida. Your mother will all use this while cooking, while making buttermilk. It improves digestion. It is used as a remedy for diarrhea and dysentery. And ginger, now we are using in this pandemic period, we are using ginger a lot, isn't it? So it helps to improve digestion. It reduces nausea. And turmeric, we are also using this. It is a common anti-infectant and it helps to heal wounds. Black pepper, it is a great remedy for colds and cough. So students, as in a, we are in a pandemic period, we are using black pepper. Why? Because it is a great remedy for colds and cough. Cloves, it helps to relieve toothache. And here in your textbook, page number 110, they have given you as activity making a juice in your home. What's a juice? Coriander juice. You can make coriander juice in your home. Try this in your home with your mother. This juice helps to reduce chest congestion. It is rich in iron, vitamin A, B and C. Now can we see how the coriander tea is made? Coriander, take a spoon of coriander seed powder, mix with 2 to 3 cups of water, add jaggery to taste, boil for 5 minutes. Your coriander tea is ready to serve. It improves digestion. Students, now we are going to see a different topic, simple scientific investigation in daily life. The curiosity of science starts from home. It is promoted by simple scientific investigation of the things that the children see around them. What is the difference between the sun and the moon? How does the television works? Isn't it? Likewise, here in your textbook, they are given some activities, real and shadow and lava in a cup. You can try it in your home itself. And the next topic we are moving on to temperature. Measuring temperature of water and milk using thermometer. temperature is used to detect our body temperature, isn't it? So, do you know who invented thermometer? Daniel Fahrenheit. A German physicist invented mercury thermometer in 1714. Thermometer is an instrument used for measuring body temperature. It consists of a narrow sealed glass tube marked like a scale. The marking shows the temperature. Students, now I am going to play a video for you regarding the thermometer. Please watch the video carefully. Children, thermometer is an instrument used for measuring the temperature. The first two long thermometers are called laboratory thermometer. And the last three small thermometers are called clinical thermometer. These two are digital clinical thermometer and this one is analog clinical thermometer. Thermometer consists of a large and very thin bulb containing mercury is connected to a capillary tube.
Here is a glass of ice cold water. This water is at room temperature. And this is hot water. Now we will take the thermometer and measure their temperatures. The ice cold water is at 0 degrees Celsius, while the normal water is at 22 degrees Celsius, which is the room temperature, and the hot water is at 55 degrees Celsius. So only a thermometer can tell us accurately if any object is hot or cold.
So students, hope you have seen the video and know more about the thermometer and how to check the temperature. So students, daily you have to take your textbook and read. See you in the next class. Thank you.